Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about file system task. So before going forward, if you haven't watched last video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video. So let's start with file system task. So in our last video we have discussed what file system task does and we have covered 6 operations. So today we gonna discuss about move directory, move files, rename files and set attributes. So let's start with move directory. So go to on SSDT, drag and drop one more file system task. And so here my plan is I just want to move temp folder into should be deleted content folder. So once our package will be executed, then this temp folder should be moved in our should be deleted content folder. So go to on SSDT, double click on this file system task and go to on operations. Here I would like to select move directory. Then here we need to make source connection, so click on new, and here we have existing folder, so we can select inside this usage type. Then we need to copy this and paste it here. Now click on OK. So we have configured our source. Now we need to configure our destination. So in our destination, where we want to move this folder. So we want to move this folder inside this should be deleted content folder. So I would like to copy this and here I would like to create folder. So paste it here. Now what would be the name of the folder? So I gonna use temp1. Now click on OK. Again OK. So once our package will be executed, then our temp folder will be moved into our should be deleted folder and rename at the runtime. So I can click on start. So package executed successfully and we can check temp folder is available over here. Now go to on file system folder and here we are not having temp folder. So we can say that temp folder is moved to should be deleted content folder. Now we can stop this package and it is used for move folder. So we can rename with move folder. Now I can disable this. The next operation is move files. So go to on SSDT, here drag and drop one more file system task. So what our plan? Our plan is I just want to move our Excel source file from this location to should be deleted content folder. So how we can do this? Double click on this file system task, go to on operations, and here inside this move files we need to select our source. So our source, click on new. So this is our source. So we can copy this file name with file path and paste it here and click on OK. Inside this destination connection we need to click on new and here we need to select our folder where we want to move these files. So we just wanna move these files inside this folder. We can copy and paste it here. Now click on OK. Again OK. So once our package will be executed, then Excel source file should be moved inside this folder. So click on start. So as we can see, package executed successfully and file has been moved. Now we can stop this package and this is for move files. So we can rename our file system task and disable this. Now we need to drag and drop one more file system task and our next operation is rename file. So how we can do this? So our plan is we just want to rename our Excel source file by Excel source 1. So how we can do this? Double click on this, then inside this operation I need to select rename file. Then it would ask our source connection. So click on new connection, and this is our file path, so we can copy and we can paste it here. Now click on OK. So we have done our source. Now in our destination connection we need to click on new, and in our existing file, so what would be the new name? New name should be source one. Now click on OK. So we can create file and we can rename. Now click on OK. Again OK. So once our package will be executed, then this file name should be renamed. Now we can click on start. So as we can see, package has been executed successfully and file name has been renamed. Now we can stop this package, and it is for rename file. So we can disable this, and in our last operation we can set attributes. So it is used to set attributes for the file and folders. It includes hidden, read-only, system and archive options. So I would like to use hidden and read-only over here. So what our plan? Our plan is, so as we can see, this is our file where we want to use this option. Go to on properties. Here we can check the attributes. So we don't have read-only and hidden. Once our package will be executed, then this file should have read-only and hidden option. So we can cancel and go to on SSDT, and here we can drag and drop file system task. Double click on this, and here we can select set attributes. So in set attributes it would ask our source connection. So click on new connection and existing file. Here we can specify file name with folder. So this is our file name. So we can copy and we can paste it here. Now click on OK. Source connection. So here in attributes, as we can see, we are having option hidden, read only and other options. So I wanna use hidden and read only. So here we have true. Then we can change this with true. Now click on OK. Save our package. Now we can execute our package. Once we executed our package executed successfully. Stop this package, and here go to on the property. So as we can see, read only and hidden checkbox checked. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. If you have, thank you so much.